गुड मॉर्निंग, आई एम डॉक्टर कान्होचरण पात्रो। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द रेडियोलॉजी ऑफ एपेनाइममा। इफ यू गो टू द इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट, एपेनाइममास रिप्रेजेंट ए रिलेटिवली ब्रॉड ग्रुप ऑफ ग्लायल ट्यूमर्स, मोस्ट ऑफ एन अराइजिंग फ्रॉम द लाइनिंग्स ऑफ द वेंट्रिकल्स ऑफ द ब्रेन और सेंट्रल कैनल ऑफ द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड। मोस्टली दे आर डिवाइडेड इनटू थ्री ग्रुप्स। It is one is the infratentorial, which is constitutes the 60%, supratentorial 30%, spinal cord 10%. Microscopically, these tumors are characterized by well-differentiated cells. Characteristic feature of the ependymema is the rosette, which is are uncommon, but pathognomonic and perivascular pseudorosette, which are far more common and seen in most ependymemas. Dystrophic calcification, hemorrhage, myxoid degeneration, even a rarely metaplasia are sometimes encountered. According to the WHO 5th edition to 2021 classifications, ependymal tumors are classified into supratentorial ependymoma, supratentorial ependymoma that is Rella Jacta fusion positive, supratentorial ependymoma F1 positive, posterior fossa ependymoma group posterior fossa group A and posterior fossa group B, spinal ependymomas, meek and amplified, mesopapillary ependymoma, subependymoma. If you see the ventricular system of the brain, you can see here, this is the two lateral ventricles connected to the, this is the blue is the third ventricle connected to each other by interventricular foramen or foramen monaro. Third ventricle and connected to the fourth ventricle by cerebral aqueduct, and two recesses in the laterally of the fourth ventricle is called foramen lacerta, and one median recess is called foramen mesendi. They all collected into the cisterna magna and subarachnoid space. This is the central canal of the spinal cord. So if you see the ventricular system, this is the lateral ventricle, this is the third ventricle, this is the aqueduct of Sylvius, this is the fourth ventricle, this is the midline foramen, that is the question of cisterna magna and subarachnoid space. Again, if you see the CSF flow, CSF produced by the choroid plexus of lateral ventricle, foramen monaro, third ventricle, then cerebral aqueduct or aqueduct of Sylvius, fourth ventricle, then foramen lacerta, foramen mesendi, and foramen lacerta, two lateral foramen lacerta, central foramen mesendi, and all collected to the subarachnoid space. If you see the cisterns, these are the most important cisterns, the intrapeduncular cisterns. This is the cisterna quadrigeminal, superior cerebellar cistern. These are the all other cisterns, prepontine cisterns, premedullary cistern, supracellular cistern, and pericollegial system, and this is the biggest cistern magna. All collectively drains to the cistern magna from the foramen lacerta and foramen mesendi. And this is the cistern magna, that is the part between the posterior surface of the medulla and anterior surface of the cerebellum. This is the cisterna magna, this is the foramen mesendi, and this is the fourth ventricle, floor of the fourth ventricle, and the roof of the fourth ventricle. So this is the foramen lacerta, foramen mesendi central, the two foramen lacerta. Two foramen lacerta and foramen mesendi. If you see, this is the body of the lateral ventricle, frontal horn, hospital horn, temporal horn, atrium, lateral ventricle, third ventricle, aqueduct of Sylvius, superior medullary vellum, that is proof of the fourth ventricle, foramen mesendi. Two lateral, this is a foramen lacerta, this is a floor of the fourth ventricle, and this is a conductive to the central canal of spinal cord. So this is the obex. This is called obex. This is the this is the third ventricle. This is the midbrain, pons, medulla. This is a fourth ventricle, superior medullary vellum, inferior medullary vellum, and median aperture. This is the central canal, and this is aqueduct of Sylvius. This is the called obex. So if you go to the histopathology, these are the rosette, rose like formations around the vessel. This is called a rose-like arrangement. These are called serosity, and these are the ependymal tumor cells arranged in around the lumen, looking like a gland, and this is called ependymal rosety. So immunohistochemistry, if you see, mostly GFAP positive, and then here epithelial membrane antigen positive for luminal surface of the ependymal rosetes, positive dot or ring perinuclear intracytoplasm structure, intracytoplasm microrosety, and S100 positive and pimentin positive. Radiological characteristics, if you see, the majority of the intracranial lumen is 60% and the posterior fossa, usually arising from the lateral recess of the fourth ventricle or median recess of the fourth ventricle. So lateral recess is known as foramen lusca, and these are the mostly posterior fossa A group of tumors, and median group of the molecular group is the posterior fossa B group of tumors, which is arising from the midline near the obex. Posterior fossa epididymis are extend through the foramen lusca and mesenteric, and it is called plastic ependymoma. You can see varieties of necrosis, calcification, cystic changes, hemorrhage frequently seen. So it, that's why it gives a heterogeneous appearance. So if you go to the molecular subgroups, supratentorial tumors, one either RELA fusion or YAP1 fusion. RELA fusion having poor prognosis, YAP1 fusions in the associated with very good prognosis. Posterior fossa A, again, poor prognosis, that is arise from the lateral recess, that is a foramen lusca. Posterior fossa B tumors, mostly adolescents and children, having excellent prognosis arising from the foramen mesenteria. If you see the CT scan, either coarse calcification may be common, mostly 50%. Cystic areas, solid component, heterogeneous enhancement, and variable hemorrhage. If you see, this is the posterior fossa fourth ventricular ependymoma, how it goes to the foramen lusca. So this is the looks like posterior fossa group A tumors. And this is the heterogeneous enhancement. As I told, there is a hemorrhage, cystic changes, calcification looks like gives a heterogeneous enhancement. This is a supratentorial, mostly supratentorial parenchymal regions. It is originated from the embryonal crest of ependymal cells, and it is obstructing the ventricle and with outflow obstruction. If you see this high grade, there is a high restricted diffusion. You can see in the hyper intense area in the tumor, solid component. And if you see the choline creatinine ratio, it is mostly 6.5. That is the MRS picture here, and decrease in a value. Choline creatinine ratio of 6.5, marked reduction of NNA peak. You can find the calcified parenchymal lesion also sometimes. So this is the lesion where it is going to the two foramen lusca area, mostly posterior fossa A group of tumors. Sometimes you can find, you have to take the neuroaxis imaging. You can see here drop metastasis in the spinal cord. So supratentorial ependymoma is a molecular lever, is the RELA fusion or YAP1 fusion. Infratentorial is the posterior fossa A group of tumors or posterior fossa B group of tumors. Supratentorial ependymoma, RELA is older children, YAP1 is the younger children. Survival is poor with RELA fusion. YAP1 fusion is the good prognosis. And posterior fossa A group of the tumors are poor prognosis. Posterior fossa B group of tumors are the good prognosis. If you see the supratentorial ependymomas, mostly intraparenchymal lesions, heterogeneous enhancement, embryonic developed from the embryonic rest of the ependymomal tissue, and people mostly present with seizures and focal neurological deficits. This is a RELA fusion, parenchymal lesion, supratentorial. This is the YAP1 fusion, and this is the group A tumors which is going to the laterally to the foramen lusca. This is the group B tumors with the posterior fossa. It is mostly going to the foramen mesenteric. So all four molecular groups are given in one picture here. Mostly spinal ependymomas arising from the spinal canal. And you can see there is some bleed. You can tell, you can see in the T1 plane, you can see there is some hemosiderin cap around the lesion. It is called hemosiderin cap sign in the spinal ependymoma. You There is a also T2 lesion. You can see the hemosiderin cap sign and with the heterogeneous intensity. And homogeneously, here another lesion homogeneously enhancing in the tumor. And there is a various degree of edema you can find. And as it is progresses, it gives the mostly weakness of the limbs, according to the location, bladder and bowel disturbances, sensory disturbances. So this is all about the spinal ependymoma and ependymoma radiological pictures. Thank you very much.